Service provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.
What is the idea of the chart window? Oh, sir, what is the idea of the text box? The ID is username. See, it is case sensitive. So when you say username, just only use the lowercase only. Okay, are you able to see right? ID is equal to username. So I can use this username ID here. I'll just copy it. So how do you copy it? Just copy it. Double click it. You copy this text. Control C. And go back to your notepad. Okay. So again, I'm showing some like who is not following, right? Just see that. See this program, what I'm doing now. First, what I have to do first, I have to enable this. I have to enable Firebug. See, I'm just clicking on this. It will be disabled. Then you click on this. It will be enabled. Then select this inspect element. Just click once. Click once. That's it. Then place a mouse pointer on the text box. You get the HTML thing. Input ID is equal to username. Right. Copy this username. See, whoever doesn't have login page, please wait for the class is completed, okay? Because if you don't get it, wait for the class, okay? I'll guide you. Please follow the class, otherwise you miss the topics, I'm saying, okay? Topics are not going to be repeated from now onwards because this is a video we are recording. We are just sharing the videos. Please follow the topics. Okay, so what we are trying to do now, we got the username. So what we are trying to do now, we are going to write a code to identify this element in Selenium. So how do you write the code? Let's see. So last week we have seen how do you create a instance of a Firefox driver. Okay. So we'll do one thing. We'll start the program. Better to start the program. So let's take this. So what we have right now, ID is equal to username. Right. We'll just keep it with us and start the program. So let me open the workspace. So I told you every day, you know, I'll just use a workspace. So let's use a workspace. Let the Eclipse open once. So I'll just change the workspace and we'll start writing the program for ID locator. So like that, every locator will get a program. So once today I complete login page, today's task is everybody has to practice on Facebook, right? So please try to identify the text box in the Facebook. I'll show you how do you do it. So just go and practice it today. Okay. Tomorrow I'll check that if you have any doubts for the Facebook. Okay. So today I'm showing in login page. So you have to practice on Facebook. That is the task for today. Eclipse is still opening. Let it open. Okay, let it open this Eclipse. I think this is still the workspace is not changed. The workspace is what we used is, one second. Just use the workspaces. H2K is our workspace. So I'll just select the workspace H2K. Okay. Because I create different workspaces. So it will be easy for me to organize the programs. Okay. Let it open. So first one is ID. The second one I'll just write down the list here. The second one, the list is name locator. Okay, name locator is the second one. That also we are going to see. Similarly, if you see in the web page, if you see in the web page, so if you see in the web page, are you able to see name? What's the name here? The name for the text box is, it is showing as name is equal to username. Okay, name is equal to username, right? So I'll just copy this. See, this is also I'm copying it. So whoever not able to see the screen, just please try to reconnect and see. That might help you all. Okay, ID is equal to username, name is equal to username. So these two things we are going to see now with the program. Let's see, start seeing the program now. Okay. See, I think last week we have seen this program, this basic program we have seen. Okay, again I'll explain you for 2 minutes. Basically, this program is to create an instance of Firefox driver. This will open a one Firefox instance. Okay, when I say get, it will try to open the browser with this URL, say google.com. So when I say get title, we'll get the title of the page. When I say get current URL, we get the current URL of the page. When I say get source, we get a view source of the page. And when I say close, it will close the browser. So these programs we have seen last week. Okay. So today we are going to see identifying elements. So I'll create a class, right click, say new class as find elements what is the class name I have written? Find elements ID locator. Okay, this is the class name I have written. Okay. So let's write a main method here. So what is the first one I'm going to write here? See, web driver is equal to Firefox. So how do you organize imports now? See, control shift O. Okay. So I need answers now. What is Firefox driver here? What is Firefox driver? It's a class or it's a interface or it is a method. Firefox driver is an, it's a class because we are seeing new here. New Firefox driver, new. Whenever you see new, it is not a method, it is a, we are creating an instance of the class. So if you have any confusion, if it is a method, if it is a class, place a mouse pointer here. Are you seeing a C here, small c? Everybody is able to see small c? Right or not? Everybody is able to see small c there. Arg.openqa.selenium, before that you see c. See, there is a small c here. You see this one? That is called as a class. Okay, you can place a mouse pointer and see it's a class or not. Okay, now you tell me. Place a mouse pointer on here. Tell me what is this? What is WebDriver now? Yes. What the interface contains? I told you in the beginning, interface contains 100% abstract methods. Okay. Cool. Fine. So now That is the objective, just for understanding. I'm asking these questions. Please, when you're not able to understand the concepts, place a mouse pointer on it. It will give some information for us. Then we can easily understand. Okay, fine. So now we need to open the browser. I think it will open the browser. This line opens the Firefox browser. Okay, this line opens the Firefox browser. Suppose, for example, if you want to open this browser using a particular URL, what is the method? What is the method to use to open the Firefox browser with a particular URL? Get method. Yes, perfect. Get method. Dot get. Okay, what is the URL I want to use now? What is the URL I want to use to open this browser? I can get that URL from the C. This login page, I'll show you after the class how to open this. Once you open this login page, you see there is an URL. Copy this. Copy this, because this is not the HTML page available in the web. This is the HTML page available in my laptop. So when you try to access the HTML page available in your laptop, you can copy paste the same URL. Okay, don't put HTTP and all, because it is available in your laptop, right? So when it is deployed on the server, you can use HTTP, because that's how the communication happens from the client and the server, right? But here it is within your laptop. Copy this. Okay, I'm done. So what I have done now, I just open a Firefox. I just open the Firefox with the URL called loginpage.html. Yes, in the real time, basically the pages will be, suppose for example, I told you, right, when you try to access from the, when you try to do automation on Facebook, you try to copy http://www.facebook.com. So let me write down here. Okay, this is how you write it in the real time, basically the facebook.com. So when you try to practice, please try to type it like this. HTTP is important, otherwise it will open the browser, it will not load the URL, because the protocol is important. But standalone HTML pages, we have to give this URL. Fine, we open the page successfully. Now we have to enter the text in the text box. Before entering the text in the text box, first what we have to do, we have to identify the element. So identification starts from here. So how do you identify elements? See, so everybody please focus on this point. See, okay, so in order to identify elements in Selenium, they have given us one method called findElement. So this is similar to get. Get will allow us to open the browser with the URL. findElement will help us to locate the elements in the browser. Okay, what the findElement does? It will help us to locate the elements in the browser. Let me write down on the notepad. FindElement method.